Hey Java developers, Javadoc has received several updates with JDK 20, including to the preview page. Let's take a look. Javadoc will now automatically generate an ID for user-defined anchors when one is not provided. The C and link tags have been updated so it's easier to reference user-defined anchors, and the preview page has received a significant update as well. In Javadoc, if a user defines an anchor in Javadoc, like here with the H2 and H3 tags, Javadoc will now automatically generate an ID if one is not provided to make it easier to link to. The generated IDs follow a pattern of lowercasing the contents of the header tag, replacing spaces with hyphens, and appending heading to the end of the ID like shown here. There are a few other rules, like if there is a conflict with another ID, then an accumulator is appended to the end, and punctuation and many non-Latin characters are converted to hyphens as well. A manual ID can still be provided if the generated ID does not match your needs. The link and C tags have been updated to make linking to user-defined anchors easier. Whereas in the earlier JDK releases, linking to a user-defined anchor like the previous examples would require using an href, now the fully qualified class name and a double pound sign can be used. The above example demonstrates this new functionality. Note that when using this feature, a label must be provided for the link or C tag. Finally, the preview page on the official Javadoc has been updated. The preview page will now provide links to the relevant JEPs for preview features included in the release. There are also checkboxes next to each JEP, and unchecking an option will remove API related to that feature. Here, only the API that is a part of the record patterns feature is shown. This can be a good way to explore the API changes associated with each JEP, particularly helpful as most content and documentation covering new language features doesn't cover changes to the core JDK API. Happy coding!